Theodore will make his sixth start in a row for the Wild. He was a third star of the week last week in the National Hockey League, and he has been playing exceptional, especially in the absence of Nicklas Backstrom. Pekka Rinne, he will get the call. He has four wins in his last four starts and has only allowed one goal in each of those games. Todd Richards is one of the most prepared coaches I've ever seen in the National Hockey League, and he has been able to get his team prepared on the road quite a bit this season. And they have won their last three road games and are 5-0-1 in their last six on the road.
Wild in white, Predators in blue. Puck is down. Here we go. It's Brodziak, Bouchard, and Havlat up front for the Wild. Kostitsyn, Gotch, and Hornquist up front for Nashville. Burns tried to slam it off the boards. Burns and Schultz starting back defensively in front of Jose Theodore. That long wrister didn't get through. Hornquist tried to chop it through. Brodziak sends it to the corner. Now Hornquist broken up there by Schultz. Ahead off Havlat. Havlat chasing it down on the right wing side. Suter getting back, turning on the puck, and it's dumped back deep, and Weber has it now for the Predators. Ahead to Hornquist. He'll dump it in. Took a hit from Zanin.
Already seeing both all-star defensemen in this game, Shea Weber and Brent Burns, doing their best to work that puck out of the zone with one quick pass. And that's one thing that those guys do very well. They make those quick lead passes out of the zone.
Drop pass for Andrew Brunette on the right side. His shot was blocked. He'll go after the rebound. Takes a hit from Klein. Here comes Mikko Koivu to the point. Right shot and glove by Rinne as Zanin found a way to get it through the traffic, but Rinne got a good look at it and made the glove save.
Well, there's Antti Miettinen back in the lineup. He was out for a few games with a lower body injury, and then he had the flu on the back end of that. So finally, talking to him yesterday, he said, "I feel good enough to go." And so Antti Miettinen right there in front, causing a screen on the 6'5" Pekka Rinne. And you'll see Rinne do that. He reached all the way down to the ice to grab that with his glove. He likes to do that, likes to trap it. A lot of goaltenders will stop it, then cover it up. Rinne figures he'll cut out the middleman and just grab it with his glove, even if the puck's nice and low.
This morning at skate here at Bridgestone Arena, there were two stick salutes on the ice when the Wild got together to start practice. And I assumed the first one was for Brent Burns, and I asked Todd Richards about the second one. He said, "Hey, we're just welcoming Miettinen back."
Yeah.
It shows that when you miss a forward, especially one of your top six forwards, you're very happy to get them back on the ice and in the lineup. Schultz leads it ahead, and coming across the line with his head down was Cullen as the puck missed him. And
O'Brien took him out, and that's one thing that Predator defensemen do very well is finish their checks. Wild forwards will have to keep that in mind, and that little reminder just came in the form of a hit to Cullen.
Burns leads it deep into the zone. Pekka Rinne will play it behind his own goal. Out of the corner, Dumont out to center. Wild will control. Third meeting of four this season between these two teams. This is the first one in Nashville. They split the first two in St. Paul. A 5-2 Wild win and a 4-1 Nashville win. Bodies all over center ice. Comes free, driven in by Madden. Glove saved by Rinne, and he's going to hang on to it. Madden just deciding to fire it on goal and head to the net for the rebound.
Well, the dangerous area is on the ice, right across the blue line, and watch right when he cuts across the blue here. Boom, the puck just gets to him at the same time. And if that puck had not gotten there right at that same moment, O'Brien would have headed off for an interference, but he timed it very well. And got to be careful, first of all, where you're passing it to, but you also have to be careful if you're the guy receiving it.
Well, both these teams playing very well on the road as of late. In fact, that was one of their keys to the game here on the scoreboard, was pretend you're on the road. Well, the Wild don't have to pretend. They're on the road, and they've played very good on the road as of late.
Well, the Predators have played very well on the road, as you mentioned, not very well at home. They're 1-3 in their last four home games, and they've been outscored 13-8 in those games.
They're offside at the Minnesota line, and we'll get a stoppage of play here early in the first period in Nashville.
The young Marco Scandella, Jared Spurgeon sent down a couple days ago. So they wanted him to continue to get ice time. And with Spurgeon playing well, and with the Wild right now with six defense, Spurgeon's getting the lineup call. So is Clayton Stoner. A lot of young defensemen on this Wild blue line, and they're looking to mature them as quick as they can.
To Koivu, hustling back, trying to break things up. Brunette looking, dumps it off into the corner. Koivu pokes it back to Burns. Quick shot by Burns, and that hit Miettinen out front. Miettinen was trying to deflect it, tip it in on goal, but he stopped it. And Koivu picks it off at the Minnesota line. Long pass out to center. Miettinen dangles the puck, now fires on goal. Glove save, Pekkarinen wanted to toss it aside, but he decides to hang on to it in a stoppage of play in the Nashville zone. Well, the Wild host the Colorado Avalanche Friday night at 7 in a key Northwest Division battle. Great tickets are still available. Call 800-745-3000, or you can just log on to wild.com for ticket information.
Actually, with the goalie's gloves the way they are these days, they have deep pockets. He actually tried to throw that puck, Dan. It just got caught in the webbing, and so he took one swipe, and he realized, I don't want to keep doing this. I might throw it in my own net. He hung on to it there. But, you know, you're going to see Pekkarinen try and catch and move a lot of pucks with that glove. He really uses it considerably.
Turnover, a backhand attempt by Legwand is blocked, didn't get through to the Minnesota goal. Zanin starts it back off of Cullen's stick, and Stoner flips it ahead. Svatos knocked it down, now picked up by Cal Clutterbuck. Clutterbuck, leading goal scorer for the Wild with 13. That equals his career high. He'll dump and chase. Rene knocked it away, knocked down on the wall, centered in front and poked out by Rene. Here's Scandella with a shot, and Clutterbuck may have been the one that blocked that one as he was trying to run a screen in front. Lead pass to David Legwand. Pulls up after crossing into the Minnesota zone, sends it around behind. Barker chasing it around behind. Thurisson got there. Loose puck in front, stolen away. A shot right on. Down goes Theodore, and he's got the puck under him.
Well, a quick little giveaway there by the Wild, and it quickly created a tense moment for Jose Theodore. I think that's the first shot that he's seen in the game, and you never want it to be when a guy picks a puck up at the faceoff dot and drives in. But, you know, Theodore, who is not a very big goaltender as opposed to Pekkarinen, he uses his the size that he does have very, very well, and he stacks the pads on that one, covering the lower half of the net. He knew that Nashville was being pressured there, so the time was in the favor of the Wild in that situation because there wasn't a lot of it.
Around the corner. Thurisson back to the right side. Weber gets it on goal, but no screen in front of Jose Theodore. He'll hang on.
Well, Weber, one of those defensemen in the National Hockey League that leads his team in points, and with that big shot, you see why. He does have a heavy shot, but he's still, like a lot of scoring defensemen, they need help in front, and that was about as clear a path to the net as you could find, and Theodore's going to stop that 100 times out of 100. Weber still got it on net, hoping for a rebound, but Theodore, in the fashion that he's shown so often lately, he gobbles that up and doesn't give up anything free.
Puck bouncing around in the corner of the Minnesota zone. Poke free ahead. Stepping back to strip the puck free and dump it back down low is Kostichin. Schultz battling along the wall. Poked away by Hornquist. Now Burns picks it up. Burns turns back. He's pressured there. Big forecheck coming in strong at the Wild here by the Nashville Predators. Centering attempt knocked away. Brodziak fights through it. Poked ahead and out through to center ice. Klein taps it ahead on the right wing side. Hornquist sends it around behind. Slowed down there by Theodore. Burns picks it up. Burns leads it ahead at center, and it's cleared up the right wing side to Havlat. Here's Marty Havlat now circling back while they change behind him. And he'll actually head off for a change as well. Now Stoner has it, and a free shot in from center ice is deflected and goes into the netting above the glass in the Nashville zone. Scoreless so far here in the Music City. Predators in blue. Puck is down. Here we go.
And there underneath the shot sign is, well, Craig Leopold, former owner of the Nashville Predators, now owner of the Minnesota Wild.
And he has the home of the draft. It's XL Energy Center.
Yeah. That's what I mean. They were the home of the draft, of course, a few years ago. And, of course, the Minnesota Wild proudly will host the draft next summer at XL Energy Center. Should be a lot of fun and a lot of hockey people around.
Bouncing puck, swing and a miss by former Wild forward Joel Ward. Flipped ahead now to Mikko Koivu on the wing. Your thoughts, Mike, on what's transpired so far here? Pace, tempo, everything you kind of expected?
Yeah, you know, both these teams are playing it fairly tight. This isn't a loose game, at least not yet. And so both these teams being very careful. They're trying to realize that these teams aren't necessarily high-scoring teams as a whole. And you don't want to open things up to your opponent too early.
Nashville coach Barry Trotz this morning had an interesting way of describing things. He said, when you lose a game in the West, you got to go into damage control. You want to come back and win the next one. And that's what he calls damage control. Both these teams. Oh, and it's tipped in front. A wrister down low, and it changed direction and caught Jose Theodore off balance.
No, that's the one thing the Predators aren't doing is damage control. They're just trying to keep damaging teams. They won five in a row, and that little nifty shot with a looked like a deflection in front. We'll get the scoring going here for the Predators. Drive to the net and shoot it, and looks like right at the last second, it was tipped in.
Yeah, Leguan got it.
Just a nice little redirection, and for a goaltender, that is a nightmare. You're really concentrating on the stick of the shooter and not always the stick of the guy driving to the net. And it was such a quick little redirect and not a very heavy redirection. It just was enough to not take speed off, but definitely change the angle of that shot by about 6 inches and right between the pads of Jose Theodore.
Wilson carrying in over to Franson, and his shot, and I think Cullen diving across got enough of that to send it wide to the Minnesota goal. Fourth goal of the season for David Leguan. Second game in a row he has scored a goal. And we'll see how the Wild react now. We see what the Predators are doing as a reaction. They're coming right back at the Wild. Leguan back in the corner. Tied up and spun off the puck by Clutterbuck. Poked to Svatos. Svatos now and Clutterbuck battle in the corner. Chipped up to Leguan. Past O'Brien, it'll come back out to center ice. Too far for Wilson. Out of the corner, off the back wall. Theodore tucks it back behind. The Wild move it out to center ice. Slides by everybody. Ryan Suter back to get it. Ahead to J.P. Dumont. Held in at the point. Quick shot goes wide of the Nashville goal. Picked up by Nystrom. Nystrom with a shot. Gloved and dropped by Rene. Suter leads it ahead. Wild pinching in, trying to hold the puck down low. Controlled by Ryan Suter. Around behind to Shea Weber. Weber out to center ice. Tapped ahead on the right wing side. Thurisson sends it to the corner. Dumont lost it. Now Schultz has it on the left wing side. He'll lead it out to center. Pushed ahead across the line, and the Wild are offside at the Nashville blue line as Kobisu touches up the puck almost midway through this first period.
Well, Todd Richards spoke this morning about having to try and get through what is sometimes called a systematic defense of certain teams, and for the Nashville Predators, they definitely play a team-like defense. And Todd Richards said, we know that it will be tough in certain areas of the ice. We need to work and compete to break through any kind of defensive system that is presented to us. And so the Wild, you just saw them go offside. A lot of times teams will force at those blue lines to try and force you to turn the puck over or throw yourself offside.
Gotch centering attempt is tipped to the corner. Bouchard sends it behind the Minnesota goal. Spinning away is Stoner. Back to pick it up. Stoner up along the boards. Held in by Nashville. Gotch trying to gain control. Poked free by Stoner. Right back into the corner. Stetson lost it there. Stoner's going to send it around.
He broke his own stick trying to chop the puck away from Clayton Stoner. I'm sure if he'd have broken Clayton Stoner's stick, he'd have a two-minute minor.
Bouchard, pressured by Hornquist, got it out to center. Dumped back into the Minnesota zone. Penalty coming up on the Predators. A slash, I believe, And as Nashville gains control in the neutral zone, the penalty is called, and the Wild, trailing by one, will get a power play chance.
You see the referee pointing to the arm, saying that, you know, you got the slash, but you got to slash the stick. You will get away with that.
Nashville penalty, number 25, 2 minutes for slashing.
Just not slashing on the arm. And the two referees in today's game, Kelly Sutherland and David Banfield, both of them replacements for the refs that were supposed to be here and couldn't get here because of travel situations. Same with the linesmen, so the National Hockey League had to make a quick adjustment and put some different zebras in the game.
Off the draw, O'Brien sends it behind. Wild with the seventh best power play in the NHL. Predators with the fifth best penalty kill, so a good matchup here.
First in the National Hockey League at home on the penalty kill, though, so the Wilds need to go to work.
This puck deflected, maybe off of Pecorine, the goaltender, into the netting, so we'll see where the faceoff goes. It's going to stay in the Nashville end.
Matt Cullen continues to play that blue line on the power plays. Wild with that top unit, plenty of guys that can score. Brunette, Koivu, of course, and all-star Brent Burns on the other point with the right-handed shot. Gets that one-timer if Cullen can get it to him.
Koivu wins the draw. Cullen to Burns. Burns centers through, missed it. Koivu hustling to catch up with it. Nice little spin move on the boards. Right back to Mikko Koivu. Koivu to the point. It goes off the stick of Cullen, who was just going to try and convert it from his backhand to his forehand.
Well, you know, good defensive teams, you can always tell, and they're typically good penalty killers too, because they understand the angles in their own zone and what they can give up and what they can't and what they cut off and give the other team. And so we'll see if the Wild are able to get around any of those nice angles that Nashville's able to present.
Good centering pass from Andrew Burnett to Miettinen, who put it in right into the pad of Pecorine. Out to the point to Cullen. Bouncing puck, settles it down. Across, off the boards to Burns. Burns to Burnett. Knocked around to Koivu. Here's Mikko Koivu into the slot. Right back to Koivu from Miettinen. Down low, Burnett. Burnett all the way across. Here's Cullen. Bouncing puck. Fires its tip. Bouncing around in front. And Kostitsyn is there to clear it away.
Well, Pecorine is a big human. You gotta find ways to get the puck around him. And a deflection, certainly one of them, and that one gave him a few fits, but the Wild, just no one at the back door there for the tap-in goal.
Under half a minute to go left in the power play time for the Wild. Rene sends it around, bouncing puck, knocked down by Bouchard. Bouchard battling for the loose puck, and it's knocked free and all the way down by Joel Ward, the former Wild. Only played 11 games for the Wild back in 06-07, but got his NHL start in a Minnesota sweater. Patrick O'Sullivan up the middle. Steers it towards the corner. Battles Weber for the puck. Pops free. Penalty time has expired. Out of the box is Smithson. Overskates it. Goes back. Knocks it to the Minnesota line. Knocked back to center. Clutterbuck trying to come up with it. Can't. Push back into the Minnesota zone. Centering attempt goes behind the goal. Hit on the back wall and a shot right through the crease in front of Jose Theodore. Nystrom with a hit, couldn't get it out. Knocked down by Havlat, who leads it ahead to Madden. There's John Madden across the line. Drop pass, picked up, no. Left out in the neutral zone.
Robesu tried to one-hand that as he came through the neutral zone on a late line change. The Wild were in the middle of a change, and if he was able to get that, he had a lot of speed against what could have been flat-footed Predators.
Wild got three shots on goal in that power play. Now have seven shots on goal for the game. Bouncing puck at the point. Franson elects just to get it down low. J.P. Dumont tried to center. Flips up in the air off a deflection. Nystrom battling to the middle of the rink. Picked up. Dropped to the point. A one-timer is deflected and goes to the corner. Another blocked shot for the Wild. Back to the point. Franson rotates it left. Bouillon with a drive right on and a pad save by Jose Theodore.
It's hard to believe that got through. I mean, see all the bodies that it went through. But somehow Theodore was able to pick that up and just boot it way back out into the slot.
Weber dumps it ahead into the Minnesota zone. Miettinen had it stripped away. Centering attempt broken up. Svatos has it in the corner. Dumps it down behind the Minnesota goal. Carried on in the near corner. Turning back is going to be Wilson. Wilson takes a hit from Miettinen. Puck is cleared ahead to Mikko Koivu. Koivu puts on the brakes at center. Tried to feed one cross ice through to Burnett. Couldn't get it through. David Leguan cut it down. And then picked up now by Shea Weber back in the Nashville zone.
It's going to be a two-hour game here, Dan. Not a lot of whistles in this one. Both teams going end-to-end here a little bit.
Barker tying up Ward, and Barker, I think, is going to get a penalty. Joel Ward just kept the feet moving, and Barker was trying to pin him there, and the Wild will go shorthanded for this first time in this one. We'll be back with a Nashville power play next. Here we go, and the Wild back home for a couple, Colorado and Vancouver, Friday and Sunday, and then on the road, Edmonton, Calgary, San Jose, a little northwest trip for the Minnesota Wild.
Well, look at Ward. He does a good job. He has his stick up, and so he keeps moving his feet, and, well, Barker tried to pin him. But if you know one thing about Cam or about Ward is he's going to continue to move those feet, and he continued to power his way down into the zone. And Cam Barker got a holding call, and so the Wild give up a few chances here unless they can get in the way of a few of these shots.
First power play of the game for Nashville. Wilson sends it across. Now Suter has it. Suter dropping it off on the left side. Shea Weber down low, dumps it in front, bouncing puck comes out, and a foot race to the puck, and Clutterbuck battling with Wilson, but it's held in. Suter being bothered by Clutterbuck across. Kostitsyn crosses there with Suter, now in the slot, tried to get it across for Wilson, loose in front, and it slides wide of the goal. Clutterbuck broke up that cross ice pass, and now Weber has it in the corner. Weber leaves it back behind the goal, picked up by Colin Wilson. Wilson out to the right point. Suter drops it off. Ryan Suter gets it back. Along the boards, Sergei Kostutin leaves it down the corner to Suter on top. He winds it up, he shoots, and it goes off a body. May have hit Theodore on the pad and goes wide of the goal. In front, Kostutin into the slot. Down low, and it goes off Hornquist's stick. Back to the point again. Suter keeps it alive in the Minnesota zone. Off a skate, and unfortunately bounced the wrong way off Matt Cullen's skate. Kostitsyn has it now, looking inside. Back out on top, Suter with a shot, tipped up into the glass and into the netting in the Minnesota zone, and the Wild will get a chance to get some fresh penalty killers on the ice. Well, the no-name brand of premium meat and seafood is looking for the no-name original kid of the year. Winners will receive a party at XL Energy Center for 100 of your closest friends, plus 100 SAs will be randomly selected to win Wild game tickets. Enter online. Just go to nonameoriginalkid.com.
Well, they're trying to figure out whether that faceoff should come inside, outside. It's obviously inside as it went off of the goaltender up into the netting.
A lot of offensive zone time on this power play for Nashville, with the Wild again keeping most of the play out on the perimeter. And this one will go high off the glass. And Koivu with a second chance, couldn't get it out. Leguan has it. Final seconds of this power play. Leguan works his way down low, centers it back out front, it's picked off. Madden shorthanded. Madden drag move, leaves it. Koivu. Koivu walking in. Backhand, he scores! Mikko Koivu, what a goal!
That was ridiculous. Oh my. And the reason why so much net was available to him is Pekkarinen was screened. He was screened by his own defenseman. So when Mikko Koivu did that pull and drag move to the backhand, there was all kinds of net. Rinne didn't know he'd made the move. What a nice goal there by Mikko Koivu. Look at the work here by John Madden. He gets it out of the zone, and that starts the play, but this quick little drop pass and then a flat-footed defender, and Mikko Koivu took care of the rest.
I could watch that one a lot.
Oh my goodness, look at Bouillon though. Bouillon was basically flat-footed, and so he reaches with the stick. Koivu goes around him. Pekkarinen doesn't know Koivu has that much speed. And he just puts a backhander in there.
You know, Bouillon has to be flat-footed because he couldn't back up any further. He was backing in. He'd been his own goaltender.
Well, also, he wasn't expecting that turnover or that quick drop pass by Madden. It was kind of poked away from Madden. Well, Koivu followed it up very nicely and aggressively. Wild tie this one up late.
11th goal of the season for Captain Mikko Koivu. Stoner got it in deep. And Barker had just come out of the penalty box, so an even-strength goal for the Wild. John Madden will get the lone assist on that goal. by Koivu at 16:05, even at one here in Nashville. Bouchard centering shot, soft shot, got through on goal, and Rene just slaps the mitt on it.
Well, that's how you score on a 6'5", 200-pound-plus goaltender.
Well, you make a move?
Make a move like that, using a defenseman as a screen.
Wild tie it up on a Mikko Koivu goal. We'll be right back. Local news of the day in the Twin Cities. First look at weather. Watch 45 local news. That's tonight after the game. Mikko Koivu has the goal for the Wild to even this one up. If they drop the puck, now they're going to do it without Smithson in the middle.
Been tossed from a couple faceoffs in this period.
Off a skate, Scandella shot, that hit traffic in front. Mietinen took a pretty good slash in the back of the leg there from Jared Smithson as the play moved out of the zone. Barker slowing Smithson down at the line, it goes off Mikko Koivu. Now Scandella going back to get it, sidesteps that check. Picked up by the Minnesota Wild captain Mikko Koivu, sends it up along the boards. Brunette chopped it out, Mietinen with a poke at it, couldn't knock it free. And the Predators knock it back in their own zone. Smithson taps it ahead. Smithson's one of the top faceoff guys in the National Hockey League. He's in the top 10, but his numbers won't change much if he keeps getting booted out of the circle. Koivu on his backhand. Tried to get it out front to Burnett, but it was knocked to the corner. Now Gotch has it. Schultz pinching into the hash mark. Backhanding it ahead is Weber, and it's stripped away at center ice by Brent Burns as Hornquist was trying to break in. Kobisu on the forecheck. Weber to center. Around Schultz on the right side. Hornquist dumps it, wrists one right through the front of the goal mouth and out the other side. Kobisu across the right wing side. Kobisu in front, and Nystrom trying to reach in and get a touch, could not get around the defender. Schultz on a bouncing puck. Hornquist will play it ahead. Bouncing and rolling into the Minnesota zone. Here's Burns with a quick turn. Burns looking up ice at center, tipped ahead. Nystrom picks it off. Nystrom had it knocked away off his stick. Wilson sends it around behind the his own goal. Wilson played his college hockey at Boston University. He's been on a nice roll as well. Six-game point streak for Colin Wilson. And Wilson enters into the zone. Made a move, Zanin got on him, Klein for the stop from the point, and a stick save made by Theodore, and it goes over the glass out of play in that netting in the Nashville, in the Minnesota zone.
Well, Minnesota Wild have their all-star Brent Burns. Brent Burns talking a little bit about that today. He actually gave some props to his D partner, Nick Schultz. He said, yeah, you know what, I won't have him there with me to cover up for me. And you know what, that's why they work so well together. Burns takes a few risks, he takes a few offensive chances, but he has to.
Minute to go in this period. Pass to the point, missed the mark on Nick Schultz.
And there's Nick Schultz back to clean up, as he does so often. And some of those offensive defensemen, defensive defensemen combinations, they complement each other so well.
Yeah, it's almost like a marriage. They're opposites.
Yeah.
There's very few similarities between Nick Schultz and Brent Burns. There's a loose puck in front. Smithson, luckily, it got by in front of the Minnesota goal. As Brodziak comes away with it. Kyle Brodziak trying to find some room and does. And Brodziak flips it ahead, but it's knocked back down by Joel Ward. Smithson in the corner. Smithson hit by Zanin. Stoner cuts his man off.
One thing about teams that are good defensively, they create transitions in those areas of the ice, both blue lines in particular, like you're seeing Nashville do. They've turned the puck over a couple times at the offensive blue line.
Bouchard and Havlat down low as the horn sounds, and our first period comes to an end. Mikko Koivu has the Minnesota goal, tying this one up. 1-1 after one in Nashville. Back with our first intermission from Bridgestone Arena right after this timeout. Second period of play. Well, time to get out your AT&T cell phone and text in for a Brent Burns, All-Star Brent Burns mobile download. Text GOAL to 83281. Find out what's possible with the nation's fastest mobile broadband network, AT&T. Rethink possible. So Burns headed to the All-Star game, and I don't know if we should maybe call ahead and warn some people. Or
he's going to be in good company, well, that's for sure.
There's only one Brent Burns, and he should be a lot of fun.
Stay around for our second intermission. We're going to show you some more highlights of what Brent Burns brings to this Wild lineup and some of the reasons why he is an All-Star.
There's Burns hustling back in the Minnesota zone. Drops it off behind the play. Mikko Koivu with the first period goal that wasn't even strength goal, but came as Cam Barker was coming out of the penalty box. Cross ice, Schultz leads it ahead. Brodziak in across the line. Havlat going to his backhand, and good stick work defensively to push him all the way back out by Shea Weber, another All-Star. Here's Marcel Gotch across the Minnesota line. Gotch slowing down, puts a wrister in on goal, and a stick save by Jose Theodore. Spalling in the corner. Now to Gotch. Zanin marking Gotch. Ward leaves it out the point. Long shot, might have been tipped the back, and they score. Turned over in front off the rebound, and Joel Ward backhands it in.
Well, Ward slipped in behind the defense, and that rebound, oh, I'm pretty sure Theodore would like to have that one back. It was a little bit meatier than he wanted to give up, and you watch how it came off of the pads. The Wild getting hemmed in early here in this period, and look at this shot comes through, and Ward just all alone there. I think the Wild felt they were going to get the puck out, and they got jammed up at the blue line, and yeah, it's just that's a gift. Look at Ward just backpedaling. Theodore tried to swat it away, but he just he knew he made a mistake there. It just came off way too generous off of that goal pad.
Ward gets his fifth of the year. You see it right there. And the Wild down again by a goal here in Nashville. The Predators scored the first goal of the game. That was a David Legwon tip-in. And then here comes Smithson leading the charge back. Ward has it. Deflected back out to center. Chopped right back into the Minnesota zone. So an early goal here in the second period gets the Predators back up at home. Klein will get an assist, and Gotch will get an assist. Centered out front. Here's a backhand right on, and then O'Sullivan at the side of the goal. Couldn't get a piece of it. Marek Svatos has it. Rotates it across the slot area. Loose puck. A couple of Wild players collide there as O'Sullivan was going one way. And
Flutterbuck will hit anything with a puck.
Well, it doesn't matter. They both are fine. O'Sullivan was slow getting up, but he's okay. Clutterbuck comes in, goes down as Bouillon gave him the shoulder. Now Clutterbuck fights through that check. Tried to dump it loose behind. O'Sullivan trying to get it. Klein rips it away. Far side, Scandella stepping up. He battles in the corner for the loose puck. Scandella reaches back, sends it around behind. Francois Bouillon has it. Turned back on the play by Patrick O'Sullivan. Now tapped out to center ice, and Burns will go back after it into the Minnesota zone. Long pass ahead to Kobisu. Rolls off his stick. O'Brien, the former Canuck, has it. Flips it ahead. Knocked down at the hash mark on the wing by Madden. Now Kobisu being leaned on by O'Brien. Kobisu trying to kick it. Squirts free. And the Predators lead it ahead on the left wing side out to center ice. Burns is there to smack it right back in. Wild 11-6-3 on the road. Impressive road numbers for this Minnesota team. What a turnaround away from home from a year ago. Nashville at home, 9-4-5 this season as Pecorine plays it across in front of the goal. Now down low, Brodziak couldn't get it, went off his skate. Now ahead, Thurisson out at center, gets spun around by Stoner. Loose puck picked up on the right side. Here comes Brodziak. Brodziak leaning in, centers in front, and Bouchard was tied up by Franzen out front.
I like to see Bouchard driving down the middle of the ice there, and someone hurt behind the play for Nashville.
Wild trying to keep the puck in the zone. The player was tripped up on the play behind the Nashville goal, and it didn't look like that's much. It's J.P. Dumont.
Dumont, yeah. But you know what? Normally a player will go down and he'll at least make an attempt to get going back to the bench, but Dumont didn't even try to get up, so he could be more seriously hurt than we think. But look at this. There's Clutterbuck. He comes crashing through, bull in a china shop, and eventually he gets it right. He runs into the right guys here and there. But behind the net right there, you see he just gets chopped down a little bit, and it might be more of a Charlie horse type situation, but it didn't look that serious, really.
No, I mean, it almost looked like something, like you're right, like something locked up on him.
Yeah, so he is, and he's still down, which is surprising given the what looked like really not that severe of a hit.
Well, the players and the trainer around him seem very calm about it, so I don't think it's, you know, something that they're real concerned
more,
about at this point.
Looks more lower body related. But just before that, and he's up, and that's very good. But look at Pierre-Marc Bouchard. Brodziak is going to throw this to the middle. Bouchard going right to the front of the net, and there he is right there. You got to love to see a guy who missed over a year with concussion problems going to the middle of the ice. And that's very important for Bouchard because that's where he's going to find goals and assists. And a good feed there by Brodziak, who was fighting off a check. The puck went through, but Bouchard just wasn't able to get his stick on it. There's Dumont slowly making his way to the Predator bench. And, you know, this here's a team that really can ill afford any more significant injuries. They're missing some significant players, as we talked about in our open. Dumont certainly is one of those for them.
All right, play resumes. Wild in the offensive zone. Stoner just flips it off the back. Comes right back out front. A backhand towards the goal is tipped wide of the goal by Havlat. Another shot from a sharp angle. This one's going to ring around and come out to center. Kostitsyn is taken off the play by Zanin. And Zanin, I don't know, he didn't got it pretty quick after the puck went by, but they're going to call interference.
Well, timing's everything. And when you lay a hit on someone or pick them or get in their way, right there, the puck. Right there, the puck just gets chipped by him, and you can finish your check, but he kind of went out of his way to give a bit of a push there, a cross check, or in this case, it's called interference. If you're going to step into a guy, you'd have to definitely use your shoulder.
Here's Wilson in front with a shot at Theodore with the save. Second power play of the game for Nashville. And now a shorthanded rush for the Wild. Madden drives one of the defenders, stepped in front of that one and knocked it up and out of play. John Madden getting a look.
Yeah, he got a look, but guess who got a better look? And looking right off the faceoff, a guy cannot be standing all alone in front like this. And right there, point blank shot. Great save there by Theodore, but you do not want to be giving these things up on a turnover in your own zone or a missed coverage.
Shot from the point was over the top of the Nashville goal. The Predators will regroup. Ryan Suter, the former Badger, slowly making his way out to neutral ice. Suter to center, he'll drive it in. Round behind Theodore. Suter will get the first touch as Kostitsyn let it go by. Now to the near corner. Dumped back behind. Sergei Kostitsyn now to Suter. Kostitsyn bumps there with Scandella, and Scandella quickly sends it all the way down right up the middle of the ice and forces the goaltender Pecorine at the other end to play it. Hornquist will slow it down, leave it back in his own end. Halfway through the power play time, interference was the penalty call against Greg Zanin. He's in the box. Leguand to the corner. Goes all the way through, around behind. Broken up. Now Leguan off the boards to the point. Franzen waiting, looking. Gives it back up on the right side to Leguan. Good battle to poke the puck free by Koivu. Koivu still battling for the puck. And it comes back to the blue line of the Nashville Predators.
Gotta love
the head by Bouillon.
Gotta love the compete level in Mikko Koivu in this hockey game.
Burns goes down, gets up, plays it to the corner. Koivu turns, can't get it out. Held in at the point. Bouillon moving in. Bouillon drops it back. Franzen shoots, hits the post, and it's cleared away. Swept away by Mikko Koivu.
There's that compete. That thing went off the post, and it just was spinning like a top right above the goal line, and Koivu dives and bats it away from the crease. My goodness.
That's as good as scoring a goal right there.
Yeah, absolutely.
Penalty time has expired. Zanin is out of the box, carried in across the line by Spaulding to the right side. And getting in too deep was Smithson. He ran out of room. Here comes Clutterbuck the other way. Leading goal scorer for the Wild. Cal on his backhand. Poke check to the corner by Klein. He'll dump it back down behind. O'Brien tying up his man behind the goal. Dump back into the corner. Ward trying to come out. Brodziak stepped in front of him. Banked off the boards to center. Clutterbuck will flip it right back into the zone. Klein going in to get it. Klein dumps it around behind. Out to center ice. Marco Scandella rotates it across. Scandella was a plus four the other night in Pittsburgh. The only time a rookie has ever done that for the Wild before was Philippe Kuba. That goes back a ways. Schultz driving it towards a goal, but it's deflected out. Cullen is on it there. He'll slow it down, drop it back defensively. Burns leads it ahead. Cullen across the line. Cullen dumps one in on goal, and a glove save hung on to by Rene. And he'll keep it there, and a faceoff coming up in the Nashville zone when we return to the Music City. Sign of a good time. Here we go.
Well, almost, and there's been a few almosts, but this one almost a goal as it squeezes a little bit through the crowd and under the arm of Jose Theodore. It bounces off the post, and look at Koivu just getting there before Legwand was able to chip it in. Yep. Good heads-up play by Koivu.
A puck sits there, and it's either somebody's going to get it, and hopefully it's, you know, the Wild, and Koivu kept Legwand from getting his second goal of the game. It would have been a tap-in for David Legwand and keeps us at a 2-1 Nashville lead. Bouillon going back to get it. The head on the right side, Hornquist. Scandella cuts it off, drops to a knee, gets it. Scandella leads it ahead. Mietnin will clear the Minnesota zone. Ahead on the right side. Here's Brodziak. Brodziak flips it in around the defender, goes to the corner, throws a shoulder, gets the puck. Tried to dump it to the opposite corner where Havlat was waiting, but it was slowed down and now cleared all the way down. It's tipped there as it bounces in, and Theodore with that bouncer will scoop it up, and we'll get a faceoff coming up back in the Minnesota Wild end.
They take a quick peek at Marco Scandella. Look at this. He bats away the puck. He fights for it, gets up. He was getting some help by Pierre-Marc Bouchard, but nevertheless, he got up and helped himself out there, made a good pass out of the zone. So Scandella, you know, he shows a lot of speed, and he shows some good heads-up plays by a young defenseman, and that's why he continues to find himself in the lineup. Good size as well.
Puck slides between the point men for Nashville. Ryan Suter back to get it. Suter's on a four-game assist streak for Nashville. Turnover, Suter chips it up ahead off the boards, knocked back towards the zone, and now Suter gets a piece of it again out to center where Havlat leads it in across the line. Back for Havlat, quick shot up high, and he missed the mark. Backhanded in by Zanin, into the slot, Brodziak with a shot right onto the rebound, just sitting there, and then it's tapped back to Rene, and he'll cover up.
Tough way to score on this kind of goaltender. Pekka Rene is so big, so strong. And he has a lot of quickness, and it's like trying to shoot the puck through a wall. Pekka Rinne, watch him readjust as he comes off of his post. Good job by Brodziak, but look at, there's just a wall there. He's already set. Even before the pass gets to Brodziak, he knows what he's going to do on this save.
We were talking this morning about when he goes into the butterfly, his skate blades are almost both touching each post.
Yeah,
I mean, he covers everything.
That's goalie wingspan.
Well, look, he's bent over there, and his rear end's up at the crossbar.
That's the thing, is that when a goaltender of that size, he's 6'5", and you know, Lindback's 6'6". So together, they're the biggest tandem in NHL league history. And when he butterflies, his shoulders are still at the crossbar. So, I mean, he has the comfort level of being able to butterfly and at the same time cover the top of the net.
It's like a prehistoric sized butterfly.
Jurassic goalie,
Jurassic,
is that what it is?
Butterfly. On its center, gloved and wristed in on goal up high, and Theodore just stood up and bounced that one off to his left off a save. Now centered again. A drive by Franzen up over the top of the cage. spinning and holding the puck in was O'Brien. Into the corner of the Minnesota zone. Now picked up along the boards and moved ahead by Cal Clutterbuck. Now Cullen chasing it down the right wing side. O'Brien got there first. Cullen went down. O'Brien up along the boards. Now Clutterbuck comes flying in. Now Cam Barker lobs one towards the goal. It goes wide. Stepping up down low is Scandella. Behind for O'Sullivan. Tips it up front, and it's trickled off of Madden and out the other side. O'Sullivan again behind. Has some room. Patrick O'Sullivan centers. Comes all the way through to Cam Barker. He'll rotate it left. Quick shot. Glove save. Dropped and covered up by Pecorine as the Wild, putting some pressure in around the Nashville goal.
This is great pressure in the zone by the Minnesota Wild, and just unable to get anything by Pecorine, but the efforts there, moving the puck, trying to outflank the defensive efforts of the Nashville Predators. And so the Wild get a much-needed line change, get some of the energy line back out there. There's Chuck Kobosu out there on that line. He was up on that Koivu Brunette line until Miettinen came back, and he played very well in Miettinen's absence.
Well, it just gives the Wild some depth, some more offensive scoring further down in the lineup, and that's what everybody wants.
Well, the Wild have actually enjoyed that quite a bit in their last 12 games. They have eight different players that have scored a goal in that 12-game stretch, and they're 8-3-1 in their last 12.
Wilson driving in down low. Great play by Scandella. He just went shoulder to shoulder with Wilson and rode him down to the ice.
You'll never get a penalty on you when you hit like that. I mean, you go shoulder to shoulder and put the guy down, take the puck away.
Marco Scandella is kind of tall and lanky, but he plays strong. He plays like a bigger guy. Right wing side, here's Miettinen. Miettinen flips it ahead, turned over to Bouillon, and the Nashville Predators take over. Todd Richards this morning was talking about the difference in this team in the last 10 games, and he said there's no doubt it's confidence. This team is more confident, and they're playing that way. Penalty being called here.
See how this one turns out.
Going to go against Nashville, I believe.
Yeah.
25 Nashville, 2 minutes boarding.
Boarding.
So that, yeah, when it's an icing call, you got to be careful not to use your body on the play. And Smithson, I think, got in there a little too aggressively. He thought he might have had the jump. And, well, you make any kind of physical contact. And here's the thing. It doesn't have to be some massive hit, but look at Scandella's legs just crumple upon impact there. And you know, any kind of contact like that can cause serious injury. We've seen it obviously before.
Yeah, we saw it in San Jose with Curtis Foster. We don't ever want to see that again. And basically what you have to do is you have to play the puck completely.
Yeah, don't go near the player, whether you use your stick or your body to make contact with them. I think it's a great rule, considering the fact that they still have touch icing.
Wild on the power play for a second time, trying to tie it up off Miettinen and batted free. Bouchard finds some space. Bouchard moving in, shot it just wide of the goal. He snapped his stick right in the middle of the shaft when he took that shot. And now Ward will club it the rest of the way down the ice. And the Wild will regroup on the power play, trying to even this game up with the Predators. Burns now to Miettinen. He'll carry in across the line. Back to Miettinen. Dumps it towards the corner. That's cut off on the wing, and it's pushed all the way back down wide of the Minnesota goal. Burns back to get it, shadowed by David Leguan. Leguan had the first goal of the game back in period one for Nashville. And the Wild will set up in the offensive zone on the power play. Dumped from the side of the goal. Backhanded in tight by Clutterbuck. Now knocked back behind the goal. Havlat trying to reach through traffic, couldn't get there. Cleared up, and it got by the left glove of Matt Cullen. He couldn't keep it in. Barker across to Cullen. Cullen taps it to Havlat. Here's Marty Havlat dumping it through the crease, and O'Sullivan couldn't get enough of it. Shot by Cullen, glove saved by Pecorine, and he'll hang on to it.
Once again, the glove. He loves using that glove. And he uses it as much as he can. And again, he catches it very low on his body and very low on the butterfly when this shot comes in. He loves to freeze it. I think he recognizes the fact. You see how he actually caught that off the top of his pad and then reacted right afterwards. But I think Pecorine realizes that the more you catch it, the fewer rebounds you're going to give up, because if you try and catch it with your body, sometimes that puck squirts out.
You see on the right, 24 seconds remaining in the Wild power play. Off the draw, Mietnin trying to tie it up. It flips up in the air. Just jumping into it was Havlat. Looked like a soccer play. Havlat just throwing his shoulder up there, trying to keep the puck in the zone, and the Wild have to regroup. Here comes Brent Burns up the left wing side. Burns on the backhand. Swept away. He gets it back in the corner. Comes loose. Picked up by Spaulding, and he'll have time to clear it down, and that'll do it. Smithson out of the box. Wild 0 for 2 on the power play. Nashville 0 for 2 on the power play. Koivu gets it to Stoner. Stoner moving in, a backhander. That was blocked by Bouillon. Here's Nystrom. Nystrom sends it behind. Mikko Koivu looking. Koivu centers in front. One-time shot. Turned away. And it's bounced back out to center ice. Stoner has it there. To Mikko Koivu.
Don't know if that actually got through to Rinne or not. I think it hit the defenseman.
There's a lot of people in front. Mikko at center. Off on the left wing side. Nystrom driving in, leans in, turns backhand right on, and the save by Rinne.
There's that wingspan.
Loose in the slot, shot blocked. That goes over the top of the Nashville goal. Good effort by Nystrom. Here's Brodziak in front. Backhand rebound. Another shot, and that goes right across the goal line.
And that should
and
be a penalty.
It is a penalty.
Knock the net off on purpose. You're going to get yourself 2 minutes in the box.
Great chance for the Wild to go right back on the power play. We'll step away for a moment and be back. How close?
Yeah, good rebound attempt there, and you can see that Franzen, by mistake on purpose, knocked the net off of its moorings. And so the Wild will enjoy another power play, and they have to start making some of these count. They buzzed very well around the net. But Pekka Rinne and his defensive core were able to keep anything the Wild threw at him out of the net.
For you young hockey players, pushing the goal off its moorings on purpose is called delay of game.
Yeah, it certainly is.
The Wild will get another power play. Had some looks the last power play. They're 0 for 2, trying to tie this game up. Cleared ahead. That's high over the head of Burns and all the way down. Theodore waits for it to come out of the corner so he can play it. Now back around behind to Brent Burns. Burns up ice. Right up the middle. Dumps it to the corner. Chases it down. Pokes it free. Knocked down by O'Sullivan. Patrick O'Sullivan gets it back. Bouchard will rotate it left. Shot from there. Right on. A big rebound on Pekka Rinne. And it goes right to a blue sweater.
I think he had to stretch to make that save. That's saying something for a 6'5" goalie.
Bouchard back to the point. Barker. Puck was rolling, so he dumps it off on the left side. Now Parker. Barker shoots and has it blocked by Joel Ward. Right back to Bouchard. Now down low in the corner. Brunette to Bouchard. Pierre Marc looking to create some space. Leaves it there for O'Sullivan. Patrick O'Sullivan looking. Now fires. Knocked down. Drops right in front. I mean, it dropped right in front of Pekka Rinne.
And that is where the size of a goaltender in this day and age, there's so many more big goaltenders, and that's where it comes into play. You make saves sometimes by just being there, and I think this quick snapshot through a crowd, he butterflied, but I don't think he fully saw it until it made contact with him, and then he picked up the rebound afterwards. Right there, it looked like it just caught a piece of his chest or his arm and dropped straight down, and once you feel the puck, you're able to find it and corral it.
Well, O'Sullivan doing exactly what you want to do. He saw an opening, he got it through.
Absolutely. While doing a lot of the right things, just not catching the last little break that they need to tie this game.
Mietnin in the corner is pinned there. Comes free to Burns at the point. Burns stops, flips it over to Matt Cullen. Cullen down to the corner. Centered in front, one-time shot, rebound, Burnett is there, and again, Rinne not giving up much. He gobbles that one up as well.
Well, Pekka Rinne, I said at the top of the show here that Pekka Rinne's last four games have been wins, and he's only allowed one goal against in each of those four games. The last two have been 40 save performances. So This guy is not going to be easy to beat, but shots like that are what the Wild need to keep taking.
Final half minute of the Wild power play. Suter bounces it ahead, and Legwand sends it the rest of the way down. Theodore will leave it there. Cullen starting it out for the Wild. To center, tipped ahead there. Miettinen knocked it down. It was Burnett who got run over behind the goal. Burns at the point. Burns' wrister didn't get through. Now it gets through in a backhand attempt by Burnett. Now Burnett leaves it for Koivu. Back for Andrew Burnett. Back to Mikko Koivu. Penalty time has expired. Wild trying to keep the pressure on. Joel Ward will lead it out. And here come the Predators back across center. Just dumped in softly by Captain Shea Weber. Cleared ahead and tipped by Miettinen into the Nashville zone. Klein going back to pick up the loose puck. So the Wild go to 0 for 3 on the power play, but see if they can carry over that momentum that they gained with the man advantage. A couple of back-to-back almost power plays. This puck didn't get out. Gotch picks it off. Marcel Gotch leads it down low, dumped in front, pushed away by Theodore. In the high slot, it's scooped up and carried away now by Nystrom, who will lead it in on the right wing side. Kobesu going in. Kobesu hit by Bouillon in the corner. Kobesu trying to stay on the puck and did for a moment. Now Klein has it, leads it ahead to Gotch. And Gotch from center will drive it in. Theodore stops it there, plays it to the corner. Madden turns. Madden was hit there by Mueller. High slot, Mueller, drop pass, wrist shot blocked. Kobesu clears it to the boards. Held in at the point. Shot from there was tipped and went wide off the glass behind Theodore. Here's O'Brien stepping in from the point. Lobs it across for Dumont. Now in the corner, centered, one-timer, and a glove save by Jose Theodore. What a stop. Theodore keeps that one out. Wild down by a goal here late in the second. From the owner and the general manager, skate with guys like Wes Walls, Mike Ramsey, Phil Housley, Brad Bombardier, and you receive two club-level tickets to the Wild game that night. You get an autographed gift, personalized jersey, and more. You go to wild.com. for all the fantasy camp details.
Well, when you're an old veteran and you can get away with some wily little moves, look at that, just lifts a stick at the last second. He just was unable to pat that one by Pecorine out of the air, but that's why Andrew Burnett is so good around the net, because he has all those little tricks that make him so good. And another glove save by Pecorine.
He gloves a lot of them, doesn't he? Hangs on.
He loves that.
Well, the Wild doing what they didn't do earlier this season, just getting that puck to the goal, and Brodziak was driving to the goal, and that's going to pay off eventually.
It's the recognition that you like to see. You know, so often players will drive to the net. Players don't throw the puck there because they don't want to waste one, or you don't want to just throw one there because they don't think it's a high percentage play. But sometimes those muddled low percentage hand grenades tossed at the net, sometimes those actually go into the net for you.
Theodore knocks that one back behind the goal. Scandella rushes the puck to center with a lot of confidence. Poked free behind. Legwand cut off Bouchard. He flips it ahead. Too far for Colin Wilson. Flipped right back into the Nashville zone by Cam Barker. Now Legwand to Wilson. Wilson to the Minnesota line, flips it around. Cam Barker tried to chase it down low, cleared back ahead. Koivu dips back inside, lost an edge, flipped back into the Minnesota zone. Hornquist got pushed off the play there. Koivu will try again. Now to Cam Barker. Barker goes cross ice, pushed ahead out to center. And Klein has it for Nashville. Bouillon has the second most hits for a defender in the NHL with 126 this season, as that puck bounces out through the neutral zone. And Bouillon leads it ahead. O'Sullivan intercepts. Schultz ahead to center, off of Miettinen, stops at the blue line of Nashville, knocked back to the Minnesota line. Hornquist dumps it in, bouncing in, shoveled away there by Theodore. Under a minute now to go here in period two. Bouillon chasing it back. Here comes O'Sullivan. He'll knock it up to the opposite side. Clutterbuck is there. Clutterbuck flips it towards the goal off a body and to the near boards. Spalling to center, hit by Clutterbuck. Into the Minnesota zone. Back goes Clayton Stoner to pick it up. Stoner takes the hit, got it to Zanin. Now ahead to Clutterbuck. Clutterbuck will flip it out to center ice. Half a minute to go here in the second. Tipped ahead by Spalling into the Minnesota zone. Joel Ward, hit there by Zanin. In comes Cullen to ring it around the corner. Suter can't keep it in as Clutterbuck chopped it by him. Shea Weber back. Now Weber gives it up. Spalling leads it ahead at center. And bounce back into the Minnesota zone by Smithson. Off the glass and out. Bouncing puck on the right wing side. Clutterbuck trying to catch up with it. And at the horn, it's chopped away. And the second period comes to an end. The Predators get the go-ahead goal. They lead 2-1 after two. Stay with us. We'll be right back in Nashville with our second intermission. The player of the game, it's simple. Just text 83281 and your choice for the Toyota Player of the Game, winner announced at the end of the game, and Toyota thanks you for participating.
I think the Wild are doing a good job getting through other areas of the ice, areas that typically Nashville locks down pretty good. We'll see how they play it. It's a close hockey game, but expect some difficulty getting through that neutral zone for the Minnesota Wild. They've done a good job of getting through there so far. But we'll see how things play out here in the third.
Mikko Koivu, the lone goal scorer in this game for the Wild. Schultz breaks that up. Koivu back. Backhands it ahead. Miettinen had a swat at it. Now bounced into the Minnesota zone. Burns is there. Brent Burns lost it, but it slides ahead. Miettinen to Koivu. Mikko turns, fakes the shot. Now fires centers in front, and that goes off traffic. I think it went off the skate of Miettinen in front. And back comes Marcel Gotsch, the German forward, the other way. Gotsch will send it around behind. Took a hit from Burns. Comes loose in the circle. Ward driving down low. Center back out front. Klein with a drive on goal and the save by Theodore. Ward leaves it in the corner. Trying to come out is Spalling. And Spalling does come away with it. Now Burns knocks him down. Now Burns knocks it out front. Koivu dumps it to the corner. Brunette will send it back into the corner. And Koivu will flip it up in the air, trying to get it out of the zone. Chopped at and sent to the far corner. Nashville comes in and really controls play on their first shift of the period. Hop the stick of Burns. Here's Joel Ward. He's got one goal already tonight. Ward looking to center. Now drops it back. Spalling has it. Picked off by Marty Havlat. And Spalling picked it from behind on Havlat to keep it in. Here's Ward down low. Oh, he snapped his stick on a little wrist shot.
Well, there's those transition areas that we continue to harp upon. And the blue lines are two very big ones. Wild did a good job of intercepting it. And then Havlat had his pocket picked again right at the blue line.
Oh, Wild. Hopefully that was just a early period storm they had to weather. That puck comes loose out in the high slot. Franzen chips it out. Here's Zanin now to Stoner. Stoner ahead. Brodziak backhands it in across the line. Hustling over is Pierre-Marc Bouchard. Ends up in the corner. Brodziak cuts in front of Franzen. Here comes Bouchard. You can hear it hit his shin pad. And it's deflected up the right wing side. And the Predators will control again. Dumped in by Bouillon from center. Hit that broken stick. Stoner had it for a moment, now digging it free and passing it off to center was Brodziak. Kobesu sends it in deep. Wild will change all five here.
Wild have yet to get into that offensive zone with any kind of numbers at all in this period.
Scandella lost it. It'd be Dumont centers, and it's picked off there by Barker. Quickly pushed ahead on the left side. Patrick O'Sullivan leads it into the Nashville zone. Comes loose at the point. Scandella was just changing positions there with Cam Barker and got there just in time to keep it in. Cullen centers, and it got right through the slot area and out the other side. Pretty good feed for O'Sullivan, but it eluded his stick. And now back in the Minnesota zone, the Wild regroup again. Cam Barker picks it up. Barker circles back in front of Theodore. Leaves it back in the corner. Scandella sends it up along the boards. Havlat made sure it got out. Kostitsyn has it now, rotating it back low in the zone. Just underway here in the third period in Nashville. Lead pass in across the line is knocked back out to center by Clayton Stoner. Dumped back in around behind the Minnesota goal to the near wall. Kostitsyn sends it behind. Hornquist is ridden off by Zanin. Loose puck to Clayton Stoner. Stoner ahead, tipped into the crowd by Nystrom, and that goes out of play.
Well, there's the second longest tenured coach in the National Hockey League, Barry Trotz. And, you know, this morning he was talking a lot about the Predators' ability to adjust to injuries and the fact that they have a continued team concept and what he called the Predator way. And it's because of the way everyone does buy into the concept. It allows them to always be in the playoff mix. Five of the last 6 years, the Predators have found themselves into the postseason and right now are looking good, although very tight in the Western Conference.
Yeah, it's any given day, you can be up and down. And he's the only coach they've ever had here, so
they don't know
any other way.
He was actually here a year before the first year because they had a lot of their staff and they had them doing things like scouting. So so they had maybe a concept of who they wanted to try and acquire. Earlier, we talk about transition games, we talk about turnovers, and earlier, watch this, Havlat intercepts it, and then, well, hello, keeps it in on the blue line, and then Ward, who scored the go-ahead goal in the second, does not get any insurance, but maybe he'll get some on that stick. Leans on it a little too hard.
Wild trying to come from behind here in the third period. They've been good on the road. They've won three straight road games. They're 5-0-1. In their last six road games, so it's been very good away from home, but they've got their work cut out for them tonight against a good Nashville team and a goalie that seems to be right at the top of his game right now in Pekarinen. Bouncing puck held in at the point, turning and looking, is falling, he scores through a screen, got it by Jose Theodore.
This is one of those shots that, as a goaltender, you hope just hits you. You hope you make the save by mistake, because I don't think Theodore even saw this one come through. Just a maze of players. Look at this. Again, blue line, not got out, and the Wild just can't find the puck out of the zone. Brunette gets checked here by Smithson, and it just turned around, and dare I say it, that transition area, and a screen, maybe a deflection, but Theodore reacted like it either deflected or he didn't see it at all. And there's that insurance marker right now, as the Wild need to start pulling out all stops here to start getting. They haven't gotten in the offensive zone.
No,
they have not, as a team, managed to get in the offensive zone in this period, and it's 4.5 minutes old.
Yeah, Nashville came out to start this third period and has been very aggressive and has played a very strong
third period. The ice is still fresh down there.
Stoner clears it back through center. Wilson, wrist shot, went off Stoner, off the boards behind Theodore. Stoner gets it back, clears it ahead, shot wide. Now it's Franson stepping up from the left point into the corner. This is Thurisson. Thurisson trying to pry it free from Stoner. Now it slides free. That goal came. Now flipped ahead out to center ice. That goal will be unassisted by Spaulding at 4:18 of the period.
Although Smithson should get an assist by proxy.
Dumped in front, loose puck, and it slides free. They had the big goaltender down and out of position, but no one could get a shot on goal.
Yeah, that's the type of shot that you're going to beat Pekarinen on, is a rebound, because you got to get him scrambling. If you can get the big goaltender scrambling, he's not as good of a scrambler as a smaller goaltender, and that's what the Wild need to do. Outflank him with a pass or a rebound or a deflection or make him scramble.
Flipped up in the air, and Barker on a bouncing puck tries to clear, held in. Poked free by Hornquist. He goes in the corner with it, and Cam Barker is there. Kobesu is there. Kostitsyn is there, now tied up with Chuck Kobesu on the back wall. Kostitsyn tried to center, It rolled off his stick, and it goes to Eric Nystrom, and Nystrom will get to center and dump it back deep into the Nashville zone. Poked around Clutterbuck. Just a little miscommunication there, and flipped ahead out to center ice by Nashville. Hornquist sends it around. Hornquist had the game winner against Minnesota back on New Year's Eve at XL Energy Center. Smithson got around Miettinen. Stoner comes across, plays the body, got the puck out. Now comes up loose in the high slot. Picked up by Zanin. Zanin sends it ahead. Deflected back. Brunette trying to get it. Koivu knocks it back to Greg Zanin again. Wild still out shooting the Predators at this point, but it hasn't been due to getting any chances here in this third period. It's 22 shots for the Wild, 20 for Nashville. Off of Brunette's stick into the corner. Miettinen comes across. Now Suter rings it around. Smithson waiting. On the left swing side, Smithson from center ice sends it in. Weber at the hash mark. Brunette trying to strip it away. Scandella is there. Klein at the point. Klein's shot got through. Stick save by Theodore. And now Koivu leads his way out to center, gets the puck back, tries to fire it in. Klein knocked it down. Now Scandella picks up the loose puck. Scandella to Havlat, who tried to fire a quick shot, but that was blocked and then cleared through the neutral zone back into the Minnesota end. Svatos knocked it down.
Another turnover for the Wild at their blue line, and that's becoming an all-too-familiar trend in this hockey game for them.
Leguan played that with a high stick. Wild getting the big goaltender to scramble, but can't get it by him. Center, to cast your vote, log on to wild.com and click on the State of Hockey navigation bar and cast your vote. The Wild trying to climb back in this one, now down 3-1 here in the third period. And running into a team on a roll and a big goaltender that's on a roll as well, as Bouchard battles in the corner. Kostitsyn will flip it ahead. Hornquist leads it back across the line. Hornquist gets it back, sends it down low behind the Minnesota goal. Kostitsyn chasing after it. Bouchard got there first, made a nice move around Sergei Kostitsyn. Now sends it back behind for Burns. Two-man forecheck. A little different than what we saw against Dallas the other night. When Dallas got the lead, there was no man forecheck in here. A 3-1 lead, and Nashville coming at him with two forecheckers. Carried in by Brodziak, knocked back out. Scandella backpedaling into the Minnesota zone. Scandella, the rookie defender, spinning away there from Spaulding. Scandella to center, in across the line. Scandella had it knocked off his stick, loose in the slot. Here's O'Sullivan with it. O'Sullivan fires a shot, and right there is the big goaltender, Pecorine, to knock it down.
O'Brien giving a somewhat protracted slew foot, or trying to at least, but no worse for the wear there in front. But Clutterbuck and O'Brien have been chatting all game long.
Well, kind of got the stick up a little bit.
A little bit, yeah. But you know, that's front of the net, and that's where defensemen have to have more net presence than anyone offensively. Pecorine again, gobbling that one up like a vacuum.
O'Sullivan along the boards. Good battle by Patrick O'Sullivan. Comes away with it to the point. Scandella behind. Cullen is waiting. Cullen with a nice move. Cullen looking to center. Turns. Now looking for space. Dumps it in front. And again, it went off a body. May not have been the goaltender, but it was cleared back out. Now the Wild on a transition. Turn it over. Here comes O'Sullivan. O'Sullivan flips it ahead. Off a glove. O'Sullivan reaching through. Couldn't get it. O'Brien around behind the goal to elude Clutterbuck. O'Brien stops, sends a long pass all the way down. This should be icing as the Wild get on it, and it is. As the Wild get the first touch, we'll go back into the Nashville end for the faceoff.
Well, there's Cal Clutterbuck. Three goals in his last three road games. Does not have one this evening. The Wild 5-0-1 in their last six games away from the XL Energy Center. And Cal Clutterbuck leads this team in goals with 13. That's a tie for his career high, which he set last season. So I think it's just inevitable that he will surpass that this year, and maybe by quite a bit.
side of the goal. Rene will just pull it in and again cover it up, being very cautious. Another faceoff coming up in the Nashville zone.
Faceoffs are going to be a big key here down the last 10 minutes, and Mikko Koivu has been battling pretty hard in there, usually against Smithson.
Smithson wins this draw. Weber sends it around. Spalling is waiting, knocked down by his skate, still in the zone. Little drop pass. Koivu in a lot of traffic to Burnett. Burnett trying to get at it. Burnett knocked off the puck. In comes Koivu in the corner, now behind Smithson. And Burnett stole that one away out of midair. Burnett working on the back wall. Weber is there. Smithson is there. Koivu comes in. Miettinen stepping in. Burnett got knocked down. And out comes Joel Ward. Ward across the line. Puck was knocked off his stick, but dumped right back along the boards. Ward sends it around behind. Spalling dumps it in front. Ward with a shot. Great save by Theodore. Back to the point. Weber's shot didn't get through. Another sprawling save. Jose Theodore with another stop, and they score! Theodore is not happy.
He's going to have a word with the referee, who, I don't know how that got through, because Burns and I believe Koivu as well were right in the crease. Theodore was down, and somehow that puck squeezed through, and I don't know from which direction it came or how it even got under him.
There was such a pile of bodies there. I don't know. Yeah, I agree. How did it get through?
Well, the shot goes deflection, then there they are batting away at it, and I just jammed away at it, I guess. He just kept jamming away at it. You got to give him credit for piling away at it, even though the Wild had guys all over the crease. A good big save there by Theodore. Then he scrambles, gets that one. But right here, as they just continue to jam away, it does trickle into the net. This is the best look at it. Two very big saves, but right there as they, absolutely. Burns got his knee up against the post. It wasn't enough to stop Spalling from just batting away at it and making this one a 4-1 difference.
Sometimes you just can't get the bounces. It hasn't been a matter of this team not working hard. The effort's been there tonight. They've been working. They've been working at both ends of the rink, and they just can't get the bounce that they need, as Jose Theodore is going to make an early exit from this game.
Yeah, and Anton Hudobin will get some time, and I think Todd Richards, more than anything, just wants to get the young netminder who was just called up on that last road trip when they were in Pittsburgh because of Nicholas Backstrom's injury. He wants to get him some time here and also maybe spur the Wild on a little bit. He's won two games, one in relief, one as a start last season. Nothing this season so far, but he's very active goaltender. The Wild maybe get spurred on here a little bit by the goaltending change.
Nystrom will leave it back. Clayton Stoner making his way up to the red line at center and dumps it in. A goal like that, it's hard to find where the Wild did anything wrong. Theodore made the save. Burns hugged the post like he should, and it just somehow went in.
I think what happened was, with Theodore kind of out of the net, Burns jumped over top of him, and you know, goaltender's equipment is soft, so it can press up against the goalpost. Burns, he wasn't able to press anything up against the goalpost, and so as he batted away at it, it went right underneath him.
Spalling gets credit for the goal, his second goal of the game, and he came into this with two goals on the season. Now he has four. We'll battle in the corner. Barker. Now Svatos gives it to David Legwan. Legwan tried to put it back to Wilson, and the Wild will intercept and just take the heat off and bounce the puck high in the air into the Nashville zone so the Wild can make a change. France and the young defender goes rink wide, dumps it into the corner. Center back across for Legwan. Scandella marking him. Legwan gets it back to the point. Now to Shea Weber with the big shot. Drives that one high over the top. I think that hit the netting. Yeah, they'll whistle it down. I think the referee lost sight of it, but the netting is rattling behind the play, and that'll bring a stop in the action. Nashville in charge at home. You can join the Wild in Phoenix, Arizona to watch them take on the Coyotes on February 5th. This package includes round-trip airfare, pregame reception, seats at the game, hotel accommodations, and more. But space is limited. Log on to wild.com for details. Get away for a little hockey in the desert. It'll be a lot of fun. Here it has been a night where the Wild have put out the effort, but just have run into a goaltender that's on a roll, and the Predators have just been scrappy and getting some good bounces and have a 4-1 lead here in the third. Hops over O'Brien's stick and out. O'Sullivan with a backhander ran out of space. Had Cullen driving down the middle with him. Now here comes Dumont back with a quick wrister, and Hudobin makes the save and hangs on to it.
Anton Hudobin last year was called up when Nicholas Backstrom was injured, and Josh Harding got injured in a game, and he went in and just made save after save in what ended up being an incredible victory for the Wild. He then started another game and won that. So he's showing very well. And with Nicholas Backstrom still on the mend right now and getting that hip checked out, he will be here until the time where Nicholas Backstrom can come back in the lineup.
And you know what? Turnover in front. Gott shoots. He scores. That's not the first turnover of the night.
Well, that's a rude awakening for a goaltender coming into a game. I mean, it has been that type of game. There's been turnovers at the blue line. There's been turnovers in the corner. But, you know, a lot of it's created. Look at how they're set up. Nashville just set up. They're taking away every passing lane. Look at this. I mean, this is a team that's up 4-1. And look at them. Just covering every last inch that they can. Not giving the Wild free rein out of the zone. And that one just a pass that Barker can't handle. It goes right onto the tape of Gotch, and he makes the Wild go down 5-1.
Havlat got a shot through. Rene the save. Schultz with a backhand that didn't get through. Brodziak swinging away at it. Now Burns from the point will keep it in. Bouchard spinning, looking for some room. Bouchard across the blue line. It's tipped out, and Bouchard gets it back. Just before the goal was scored, I was going to say, you maybe can relate to what Hudobin's feeling, getting a chance to play at this level, getting the call up. Then they scored on him. Well, maybe you still can relate to how he feels. That's a tough one for him to have to face. But is there kind of a panic feeling like I've got to do well? This is my shot. I got to take advantage of it.
You know, I don't think in this circumstance that Hudobin would be thinking that way. I think he recognizes that while the Wild have their goaltenders, it's going to take an injury situation or something of that nature for him to get up here. And he didn't know whether he was going to get a start or not. He thought he might get one on Sunday on that tail end of a back-to-back. But the Wild elected to go with Jose Theodore, and they dropped that game 4-0. Well, he's getting some minutes here, and you never know. He might get a start here in the next couple of games. The Wild play Friday. They also play on Sunday. That's six straight starts for Theodore, and so not that he's getting tired by any means, but maybe a start for Hudobin is in the works. You never know.
Brunette pokes that one around Bouillon, but Klein comes across and scoops it away, but Brunette won't give up on the puck. Brunette almost knocked it free. Now it's flipped up along the glass, held in the right corner. Bouillon is there. Burns runs into the referee. Burns centers, left behind the goal. Here's Koivu working through the corner. Koivu out to the point. Scandella sends it around behind, off of Mietinen, tried to center. Now it's Koivu in the corner. Koivu behind for Andrew Brunette. Brunette strips free. Brunette has a little room. Brunette walks out front. Koivu with a backhand and stopped and covered up by Pecorine. Look at the way he covers the ice. There is no room to get it by him. We'll be right back.
To get the second goal. Look at those.
Look at that
goalie wingspan there. As we talked about, one skates on one post, the other's on the other post, and there's not a lot left in the five-hole area. and he makes a save. I mean, you talk about goaltenders cutting down the angle. He's the size of a goaltender where he doesn't always have to cut down the angle. He can clog up the net just with his big body when he's sitting on the goal line.
Isn't usually the theory on a bigger goaltender, then you got to make him move.
You got to make him open up, yeah, because there's going to be bigger holes. You got longer legs and longer arms, therefore there'll be bigger holes when you do move. But he does move fairly fluidly for a 6'5" goaltender. He's not even the biggest goaltender in the tandem. I mean, there's Lindback is 6'6". That's just a couple of the biggest goaltenders in captivity.
I'm working with a big goaltender. Over the top. Yeah, we'll leave it at that.
Fill the net. Fill the net like I used to.
Barker spun off, held in at the right point by Thurisson. Now flipped ahead by the Wild and down the ice. It will not be far enough for an icing call. 4.5 remaining here in the third period. Wild will fly home tonight. They then get set to host Colorado in a Northwest Division game on Friday night. Centering pass broken up. Wild coming back the other way. Kolbisu looking for Madden, intercepted, knocked through the neutral zone. Zanin going back to get it. Nice from out at center. Flips it out of play, stopping the action. Well, as I just mentioned, Avalanche in town. Take on the Wild on Friday. Watch that game right here on KSTC Channel 45. You get to a divisional game and it just becomes a little more important. The teams are a little more familiar with each other and usually turns out to be an interesting night.
Yeah, not only to get one divisional game, they get two at home and then they go for two more on the road right after that. So four in a row here in the division after this one.
Svatos, who used to play for the Colorado Avalanche, sends it down behind. Stoner picks it up. Wilson took a pretty good hit there from O'Sullivan. Leguan trying to keep it in. Got by Wilson. Got by Patrick O'Sullivan. Held in by Franson, and he rings it all the way around. Clutterbuck on the far side. Lost an edge. I think he went for a hit and didn't find a body and went down. Brodziak sends it around behind. These two teams will meet again now. One more meeting here in Nashville. It'll come on March 10th. And that would complete their four-game season series. Kostitsyn, drop pass, Gotch, chopped one, bounces it wide of the Minnesota goal, and Anton Hudobin. Here's Bouchard, going rink wide to Havlat. Havlat ahead to Brodziak across the line. Brodziak runs into a hit there and sends it in. Gotch backhands it around. Good battle on the near wall with Bouchard, but Hornquist got it ahead, and they're offside at the Minnesota line. That'll stop that Predator rush.
Well, you always hope that you learn something from every game, and the Wild have been playing against a couple teams here now in a row that don't allow you to get through the neutral zone or the offensive zone unscathed. They don't even let you get out of your own zone, for that matter, unscathed. They force you to make good passes. They force you to work hard, like this right here. The forecheck's always on. Dallas did that. Nashville does that. Phoenix does that. They're very difficult teams, and when the Wild face a team that they can free flow a little bit more, they generally have better numbers against teams like San Jose, Colorado, on the last road trip, Boston and Pittsburgh. Those are teams that'll work you a little bit, but they'll still leave you some room out there.
Nashville will head out on the road after this. Their next game is Thursday. They play at Florida. They're going to escape this horrible winter weather here in Nashville. They got a little bit of snow and everything's shut down.
A little bit of snow. That's funny.
Brunette dumps it deep into the Predator zone. Stoner will go back behind the Minnesota goal line. Takes the hit. Got rid of it. Up along the boards, turning and trying to chop it out was Eric Nystrom. J.P. Dumont rotates it left. Now Dumont gets it back, heads through one man up the middle. Dumont across the Minnesota line. Little drop pass on the way, back to the point. O'Brien to Franzen, shot it up high, Khudobin knocked it down. Nystrom on the wing. Nystrom leads it out to center. Madden chasing after it. O'Brien cut that one off. O'Brien came over from Vancouver in a trade back in October, early October. Has just added to that shutdown type of defense that they like to play. Final minute of play here in the third period. O'Sullivan leads it all the way down. They wave off the icing. Bouillon goes back, pokes it away from Matt Cullen. Spalling ahead. In the slot. Fires, shoots. Down goes Khudobin. The shot never got through. Still didn't get through. Spalling was looking for the hat trick. Now Cullen at center. Sends it to the opposite corner. Cullen behind. Stripped off his stick. And now Nick Spalling has it again. Here comes a chance in front as Kobisu almost stole it and walked right out in front of Pecorine. Dumped back into the Minnesota zone for Eric Nystrom, and fans here at Bridgestone Arena on their feet, appreciating the effort from their Nashville Predators as the final seconds tick off. And Nashville gets a big 2 points in this very, very tight Western Conference.
Well, now the Wild are faced with, obviously, they're not in a position just starting the second half for must wins, but they need to turn this around. You can't afford losing streaks as long as you're last winning streak.
It's damage control, yeah, as Barry Trotz said.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, you can't afford to let yourself circle too far down here. So the Wild, couple of very, very big home games coming up Friday and Sunday against divisional opponents.
We'll be back with more from Nashville. The final score, Nashville 5, the Wild 1.